Smart Culture, Mathematics.
Now, previously we've learned about quadratic sequences and we've learned how to go about determining the formula or the rule for the nth term of a quadratic sequence. Now we'll move on to cubic sequences. And cubic sequences are characterized by the fact that the third difference between its terms is constant. So in quadratic sequences, the second difference between its terms is constant. But in cubic sequences, it's only the third difference between its terms that will be constant. So when we learned about quadratic sequences, we've used the formula Tn is equal to n squared plus bn plus c. Now, when we work with cubic sequences, we'll use a different formula. We'll use Tn is equal to an cubed plus bn squared plus cn plus d. We can determine the rule for a cubic sequence by using the following four equations. So a plus b plus c plus d is equal to the value of the first term. 7a plus 3b plus c is equal to the difference between the first two terms. 12a plus 2b is equal to the first second difference, and 6a is equal to the third difference. So we'll use these four equations to determine the rule for the nth term of a cubic sequence. So let us take a look at this example. Here we have a sequence, negative 6, negative 8, negative 6, 6, and 34. Let's determine the first difference. The difference between negative 6 and negative 8 is negative 2. The difference between negative 8 and negative 6 is positive 2. The difference between negative 6 and positive 6 is equal to 12. And the difference between 6 and 34 is equal to 28. Now we'll move on to the second difference. The difference between negative 2 and positive 2 is equal to 4. The difference between positive 2 and positive 12 is equal to 10. And the difference between 12 and 28 is 16. Moving on to the third difference, 10 minus 4 is 6, 16 minus 10 is 6. So you can see here we have a constant third difference of 6. Now remember, a plus b plus c plus d is equal to the first term, negative 6. 7a plus 3b plus c is equal to the difference between the first two terms, so that is negative 2. 12a plus 2b is equal to the first second difference, which is 4. And then 6a is equal to the third difference, which is 6. So let's solve for a. 6a is equal to 6, so that means a is equal to 1. Next, we want to solve for b. 12a plus 2b is equal to 4. We know that a has a value of 1, so we'll sub in the value for a, which is 1. 12 times 1 plus 2b is equal to 4. Now we'll take the positive 12 over to the other side because ultimately we want to get b alone. We want to solve for b. So then we have 2b is equal to 4 minus 12, and that equals negative 8, divided by 2 is equal to negative 4. So b is equal to negative 4. Now we have the value for a, we have the value for b, and we want to determine the value for c. So we'll use the equation 7a plus 3b plus c is equal to negative 2. We know that a is equal to 1. We know that b is equal to negative 4. So then we have 7 times 1 plus 3 times negative 4 plus c is equal to negative 2. 7 minus 12 is equal to negative 5. So we have negative 5 plus c is equal to 2. And if we take the negative 5 over to the other side, it becomes a positive 5. Negative 2 plus 5 is equal to positive 3. So c is equal to positive 3. Lastly, we want to solve for d. So we know that a is equal to 1. We know that b is equal to negative 4. We know that c is equal to positive 3. 1 minus 4 plus 3 plus d is equal to negative 6. 1 minus 4 plus 3 is equal to 0. So that tells us that d is equal to negative 6. So now that we know the values for A, B, C, and D, we can just sub these values into the formula to get the rule for the nth term of this specific cubic sequence. So A is equal to 1, B is equal to negative 4, C is equal to positive 3, and D is equal to negative 6. So that means the rule for this cubic sequence will be equal to n cubed minus 4n squared plus 3n minus 6. Now, what we'll do to test this rule is we'll determine the value of the second term using this rule. So instead of n, we write 2. 2 cubed is equal to 8, 2 squared is equal to 4, 3 times 2 is equal to 6. So then we have 8 minus 4 times 4 plus 6 minus 6. So the plus 6 and the minus 6, the positive 6 and the negative 6 will cancel out. 8 minus 16 is equal to negative 8, and this is indeed the value of the second term, so we know that this rule is correct.
For online tutoring or additional resources, visit our website, www.smartculture-education.com.
Subscribe down below. It's easy.